Okay, so we'll start directly into jumping into the numbers and a couple of elements I wanted to highlight before handing over to Ayet and go into the deep dive. So as you know, it's been very bizarre year at the end of the day with the COVID pandemic and its economical consequences that impacted all of our regions, starting with Asia in Q1 and Q2, Q3 being strongly impacted in EMEA. But despite this very profound impact on our economies, we managed to still grow by 10% last year, which is, I think, an amazing performance compared to our peers. We also managed to increase very sharply our results to up to 14 million in EBITDA. And all those figures, I think you guys knew already as they were announced in January and in October. What's very interesting, I would say, compared to previous year, is also the transformation of this EBITDA into net income with 9 million euros net income for 2020 compared to the minus 4 million adjusted net income in 2019. And I think it's the real translation of how profitable our business model is. Also, we'll share some elements on 2021 with the start of the year being still very strong with 12% growth. It's a quarter very hard to defend Q1 since last year, Q1 2020, was still a pre-COVID, a completely pre-COVID comparison, especially in Europe and France. So we are very happy with that that level of growth, and we do believe, as you can see, that we'll further accelerate in terms of growth for this year, since we expect to reach a gross margin above 80 million for the full year 2021, and to further increase our profitability with an EBITDA between 22 and 25% compared to 20% this year. So I'll hand it over to Ayet to detail further our P&L balance sheet. And Ayet, if you're...
Thanks, Guillaume, for this overview. So quick comments on the 2020 growth. As published last January, the group has recorded a good plus 10% growth at 70.3 million euros. This good performance is driven by several elements. The first one is the results, I would say, of all efforts made by the group to structure its activities on high added values offers, and the high success of data offers, so data marketing and data consulting, which are growing up by almost 60% compared to last year and pro forma, is the proof that the group has achieved its transformation. The other elements are more structural, so the evolution of the market to digital transformation, and especially the growth of e-commerce during the health crisis, has led the brand to be more consumer-centric, to reach a direct access to consumer, and has offered to Artefact huge opportunities in 2020. So if we go deeper in the figures, after a solid H1 at plus 10%, the growth has accelerated in H2 with a plus 11%. The strong performance has been very high in Q4 with a 17% growth. At this moment, the group has returned to pre-COVID growth levels. So all the regions of the group are concerned on this good performance. France first, which represents half of the global gross margin. The growth is up 20% to 34.6 million euros. In the rest of Europe, despite the slight decreasing of minus 8%, recovery has been initiated in Q4, especially in Netherlands and in the UK. And in the other market, the growth is still on track with a very good growth of 19%. So now I will jump into the EBITDA, which is the core element of this financial communication. So the group has reached a very high level of profitability this year, as the group EBITDA amounts at 13.9 million euros, so almost 20% of the global gross margin. As we have mentioned it a couple of times in the previous presentation, you know that over the past 2 years, the group has invested a lot of money to structure its activities. So we have spent money to structure our support services to deploy a strong brand across the world, to deploy financial tools, to structure the HR teams. We have spent money to deploy the data consulting and data marketing teams. And Guillaume will detail further in the presentation the ramp-up mechanism. And we have also invest money to close the non-strategic geographies. We have closed the Nordics, Italy. We have recently sold our Spanish joint venture. So now we are focusing only on a high potential geographic region. And with the opening of the US office, we are now present on the three most dynamic marketplaces. So this strong profitability concerns all the areas of the group. In France, the level of profitability is very high, with an EBITDA at almost 10. Can you? Yes, thanks. With an EBITDA at 10 million euros, which represents almost 30% of its gross margin. So it's definitely confirmed the artifact business model of growing and profitable company. In the rest of Europe, the profitability has been sharply improving by 3.8 million euros. And the level of EBITDA margin is is getting closer to the market standards, especially in the Netherlands and in the UK. And in the other markets, the region has contributed at 2.1 million euros thanks to a solid growth. So this profitability concerns the EBITDA, but also the net income. So now I will comment the detailed P&L. So the rising profitability is driven, as I mentioned, by the growth, but also by the operational cost control. As you can see, the staff cost has perhaps slightly decreased by 1.3 million euros, which has an opposite effects of strong recruitments of build team, but also the resizing of the support functions. At the same time, the operating expense have strongly decreased from 11 to 8 million euros, which reflects the end of all the structuring efforts I mentioned previously. So after impact of amortization and the non-recurring income, the operating income of group amounts at 11.8 million euros compared to a loss of 3.3 last year in pro forma. After financial income and tax expense, the net income from continuing operation is at almost 9 million euros, which is quite satisfactory. So quite comment on this P&L, you know that we usually communicate about an adjusted EBITDA. This year, we have also introduced a new indicator, which is the adjusted net income. Which is adjusted mainly from the IFRS standard without mostly any cash impacts, which not reflect the operating performance of the group as tracked by the management. For example, we have adjusted the impact of share-based payment, which have no cash impact, but we have also restated the positive impact of activation of income tax assets resulting from the losses carry forward. Okay, so the group can count on a good profitability, but also a good financial structure. At the end of the year, the cash position amounts at almost 28 million euros compared to last year only 14.7 million euros. And on the other hand, the financial liabilities at 30.2 million euros includes the 21 million euros raised last December in debt repayable at maturity and the French PGE for 6 million euros. And a word about this PGE, given the strong financial structure and the good commercial outlooks, the group intends to fully pay back this PGE within the coming months. So overall, the net debt is quite low at 2.2. And I will now comment the cash generation process, which is another key element of this financial communication, because we are very proud of the healthy operating cash flow at 7.8 million euros to be compared to an adjusted income at 8.9 million euros. So almost all the net income has been transferred in cash. This is possible thanks to a high level of EBITDA, of course, and also a WCR under control despite the growth. The 3.4 million of non-recurring concern the cash impact of restructuring plan initiated in 2019. The investing cash out for less than 1 million includes the earnout under the Chinese acquisition. And the financing cash in for 10.5 million euros is the net impact of several elements. So the 21 million euros raised in December and the related repayment of the existing senior debt, the French PGE, of course. And the rest of the variation is due to interest repayment and factoring variation. So at the end of the year, the group can count on a high cash position at 28 million euros, which support the growth in 2020. So a quick reminder of the growth trajectory in 2020. After a strong Q1 at 17%, based on a strong momentum in France and in other markets, the Q2 has been impacted negatively by the COVID and the related media cuts, especially in tourism and in travel. A recovery has been initiated in Q3 and definitely achieved in Q4. So the Q1 seems to be quite in line with the 2020 growth trajectory, with a 12% growth at constant rate. So in detail, the other market are still very dynamic with a 22% growth, especially in Dubai and China. The rest of Europe are showing very positive signals with a good performance at 16%. Mainly led by the Netherlands and the UK, which are growing up by almost 40% in overall. And in France, the 6% growth is quite below expectation, but an acceleration is expected for the rest of the year. So in a nutshell, so the first quarter is quite promising, confirms the growth trajectory. But the best is yet to come, and we are expecting an acceleration in the coming quarters you mentioned it, the 2021 growth rate should be around 15 to 20%.